Hello, and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today, I'll be reading Balduran's Logbook, which I found right here in Balduran's ship. It would appear that time has not been kind to the pages of this tome, but snippets of information are still readable. This is the logbook of the good ship Wandering Eye, under the command of the most earthy Balduran. We'll return once we have again seen far-off shores. The men are restless, but the promise of wealth rivaling our last voyage will keep them well in line. Weather is clear, and we shall make Ancarom in goodly time, of that I have no doubt. Have calmed the crew, though nervous they will remain. I blame them not, for it was not a pleasant encounter in the least. Bloody elves would do well to remember that the sea belongs to no one save the gods that guard her. I shall avoid the northerly passage just the same, if only to prevent another overzealous boarding party. Such paranoia from the fair folk. Arrived in Ancarom, and am remembered by a goodly number of people, not all fondly. But His Grace has deemed me worthy to proceed through his lands. I am quite sure the 200-strong complement of the Wandering Eye aided in the decision. Still, we were received in good humor, and I will not request tribute. Adventure has been such wealth as this, only in the deepest ruins of home. Here it is almost for the taking, with only a measure of diplomatic discussions as the cost. Attacked, and barely made it to the ship in time. Dredeel did warn of such, but who is to trust a word from his mouth? I do swear, his senses seem addled at the best of times. The crew, but a larger share for the remaining, will keep them well and truly happy. I shall conscript replacements from the local populace this night, and we shall set our sails at dawn. Delays, but with 150 new hands, one must expect the going to be slow at the start. They seem quite calm and orderly, not at all as I expected. Should have searched. We cast him out, but his words. And he inflamed the crew. I know not what was worse, the shaman's constant, or the reaction of the crew when he was committed to the sea. Their eyes are... and resigned. I dislike a crew with no fire in their bellies, but I do suppose it is better than a fire in the hold. Weather unseasonable, and the mood does worsen. As well, beetles have beset the food stores, and we shall surely be hungry long before reaching the coast of home. Set aground to forage. It is a small isle, but will yield what we need. Perhaps I shall, on my own while the crew, time on land will do them good. Original men seem quite shallow in the face, quite different from the pallor of the new recruits, but all are most definitely ill. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate, Balduran's Logbook.